attending this special Board of Education meeting. This is a public meeting of the school board of the West Bend Joint School District Number One. More than 24 hours prior to the meeting, notice of the time, place, date, and subject matter of this meeting was posted in each school building, the entrance doors at the Education Services Center, and at the West Bend Community Memorial Library. A copy was also sent to the Daily News, WBKV, the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel, and other media sources that have requested notice of our meetings. So at this time, we'll stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And then I accept a motion to approve the agenda.
I move to approve the agenda.
Second.
I move to amend the agenda to include public participation after a presentation and explanation of the action item, high school administrative assignments, and before board discussion and voting.
So we'll share as a board the discussion, the reasoning for being here, and then invite the public to share their input, and then go back if there's a necessary action we can take at that time. With the amended agenda, motion to approve.
Just to be clear, we're gonna, in a sense, be swapping item number 4 and 5.
Not quite. We'll be splitting number 5 with public participation in the middle before a vote is taken.
Before a vote is taken.
Yes.
Okay.
So I'll introduce the topic.
We need a second.
I second that. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. Thank you, Monty, for that. So in that case, I will open just with a statement to kind of set some clarity for this timeline. I thank you for being here for the special meeting of the West Bend School Board. As many of you know, there's been an ongoing process for months to recruit and hire the next principal to lead both East and West High. Our original hire, Mr. Jaredon Clark, resigned to accept an assistant superintendent position in his local Mequon community. As is often the case, when one door closes, another one opens. Reposting this position allowed for more community feedback, and the board does serve as the eyes and ears of the community. My own participation recently in a listening panel, hearing the vast responsibilities of this position, resulted in the panel addressing me personally. They said, "When will the board reconsider the high school principal arrangement?" When the board convened an executive session earlier this week to discuss the potential promotion of personnel, this question was again raised. To honor the need to discuss important issues openly with the public, we agreed to call a special meeting for this relevant and timely topic. In addition, we were hoping to stay true to Superintendent Olson's original timeline of announcing the new high school principal at the July 24th, that's Monday, board meeting. The board has a responsibility to do our best to set the students up for success. To accomplish this, our administration must also be positioned well within their roles. Currently, we have one principal and 5 assistants. The number would not change. We would likely return to the structure that has been proven to be most successful, one principal with 2 assistant principals for each school. And before I turn the discussion over to the rest of the board, I'd like to share 2 email snippets that I received from 2 highly regarded former principals within our district. They both, well, Amy Curler actually expressed interest to be here tonight, and she wasn't able to make it. And this comes from her husband, Jim, a former principal here. And he says, "One of the things I always prided myself on was being visible and getting to know the students and parents at my school. This was impossible when I was in charge of both buildings and was something that negatively impacted the school culture. My true opinion would be to go back to the separate administrations and find 2 people who can work together for the betterment of the system." And then finally, I had the pleasure of speaking with Pat Garden today. While he would have liked to have been present tonight, he did give me permission to share a few thoughts from an email he originally sent to the former board, February of 2016. And he says, "I've been periodically observing the happenings at the high schools for the last few years. I figure that 25 years of service as a West administrator provides some unique insights. Return to the concept of smallness and return to a principal and two assistant principals for each school. The structure allows for a sense of community, school pride, and identity. The structure allows for a high level of accountability and the formation of quality personal connections with our youth, something youth need and desire as they grow into adults. The response to parents and students is more timely with this arrangement, and they know who you are and where to go to find information. A high level of visibility at special functions, including the athletics and arts, truly does matter. With the present setup, this is impossible. Positive connections matter, and all else radiates from that view. In closing, he says, I know the timeline is short, but I would ask that you step back and reflect on what is best for parents and students of the West Bend School District. Hiring a new person with the same structure will provide the same results. School boards can and do make a difference. So I really appreciated that feedback, and as a board member, I'm simply an individual. So I absorb a lot of information from parents and students, teachers, administrators. But the good news is we have to come together as a board to really discuss if what we're hearing is consistent with what the community needs and desires. So that's a bit of my viewpoint. I certainly open it up for discussion among the board.
If I may, Nancy, we told everybody that you were running a hair late.
Thank you.
My car doesn't run as well when it's hot outside either, so.
Darn Highway 41.
No problem. I just wanted to let you know that before you got here, we changed the agenda to put public participation after this section of the agenda, which is basically a discussion of what Tiffany just read. So I want to make you aware
Thank
of
you.
That.
Any other considerations?
Tiffany, I think you did a good job explaining everything that I had planned on saying. So. I guess maybe I'd like to highlight that I know there's been some public questions about the reason for having this meeting tonight, and you know, so out of the blue, and that's because we do want to have the opportunity to take action in order for this school year to have the new arrangement. So we think that's what's best for students, and some of us have been hoping that things would move along a little faster in the district, and so I'm pretty happy about this.
I can give a couple of comments. Jared Clark was hired right before I became a school board member, and I did have an opportunity to meet him. I do think it's unfortunate that we're not going to get him. He seems like a great person and a strong leader, and I guess congratulations to Mequon for being able to keep him. But that being said, since I've been elected to the board, I've heard overwhelming support for taking a look at putting two principals back in the high school. People that come up to my wife and I when we're sitting at Buffalo Wild Wings to say, I remember when I went to school here and that worked when we had it that way. Or people that said, my kid just graduated and I think we should take a look at going back to the way it was, that sort of thing. So overwhelming support and feedback from the community since I've been elected. With Jaredon not coming and a school year fast approaching, I don't think we need to be taking a whole nother school year to dive into this. We just got the communication audit results back and sent out to the community. I think it was pretty clear from that audit that the people that participated in that audit, this is what they want. So I'll be in full support of this. I do look forward to public comment here tonight. Thank you all for coming. Please feel free to express one way or another on this topic. So thank you.
I would just like to say that I would welcome everyone here this evening, and I'm ready to hear your comments. I will defer any of my comments until I hear. Thank you.
Similar to Monty, I've been in the district for quite some time, so I've seen our system work with two principals. I did not have kids at the high school at that time, but I've heard from many of you that that is the preference. Had the opportunity to speak to Jim Curler and to talk to him about the idea of one or two principals, and I would think that for any job, when you're trying to represent two schools or two communities or even two different businesses, it's extremely hard. So I hope, you know, this is one of the impetuses, I think, for all of us, that we can continue to move forward and instill school pride and have a principal for each school, which will hopefully help our students to identify better and move forward and go back to our east-west scenario that we had for many, many years. So I'll defer additional comments. Thank you all for coming on a very warm night when you all could be out swimming or doing something. So thank you for being here, and we look forward to hearing from you.
So, Monty, you're going to reply after public participation?
Yeah.
Okay. So I have Amy Kieser request to speak. During the public, I'll read to you a little bit as far as the public communication part. District residents desiring to address the board should obtain and complete the district resident card. Comment cards are only for use by residents of the district. Completed comment cards will be turned into the Board of Education president prior to the start of the meeting. Comments may involve agenda items or matters not on the agenda. Cards will be accepted until the official opening of the meeting. The board president will determine if residents who turn in cards after the start of the meeting will speak. This public participation time is typically 20 minutes. And 2 minutes allotted per person. I have my stopwatch, so activate it.